What's up everyone, I'm Chirag and welcome to part 5 of the tutorial series on AWS HTTP API. So guys, in this tutorial, we will go through the query string parameter within HTTP API and we will see how we can pass the query string parameter and access it within the Lambda function or the backend integration that we have, right? So basically query string parameter is a key value pair that we pass as a part of the URL. So here within HTTP API, we don't need to configure anything at the API level for passing the query string parameter. Here we will simply pass them while invoking the API endpoint and API will proxy the request to the backend integration. It means that it will proxy the request to the Lambda function that we have as a part of the backend integration, right? So let's get started. So as we know that we don't need to make any change over here. So we are simply going to copy the invocation URL. So it could be a default invocation URL, right? That belongs to the default stage, or it could be a manual stage that you might have created in the previous tutorial. So I'm going to copy the manual stage, the invocation URL, and I will open Postman and paste the invocation URL over here. So before invoking that, we might need to add a line in the Lambda function. So for that, we will navigate to the Lambda function, that is HTTP API-Lambda in my case. So what we are going to do here is we are going to modify a code. So here we are going to say print event. So the reason that we have added this line is that whatever request that comes in, we want to see that, right? So that's the reason we are going to print the event and we will see what all data that we are getting within the event. And we will also get the query string parameter in the event itself. So let's have a look. So let's navigate to the Postman. So here we are going to invoke a resource that is first resource, or you can also invoke the test resource. So this is the first resource and here we are going to pass the query string parameter. So to pass the query string parameter, you will enter a query string that is a question mark and the key value pair. So I'll say test equal to hello, something like this. And the method is get. So we are going to select the get method from here and we will say send. So the request is successful. We received the status code 200 with the appropriate message that is coming from the Lambda. So now to look at the query string that we have passed, we will navigate to the Lambda function. We will click on monitor and we will say view logs in CloudWatch. Now we should be getting those data or that query string parameter within the event that we have printed. So here we have the log, so we are going to open it. And as you can see, this is the data that we are getting in the event, right? So here we will search for query string. So here, as you can see, here we have raw query string that is test equal to hello. And further, if you drill down, you will get the key as a query string parameters where you will be able to see the dictionary. That is the key value pair that is test as hello. So basically this is how you can pass the query string parameter. So like REST API, we cannot validate the query string parameters at the API level within HTTP API, but HTTP API does offer query string transformation and that is something we will look at it in the another tutorial. So guys, this is how you can pass the query string parameter. No additional configuration is required at the API level. Right. And as I mentioned, we cannot validate the query string parameter at the API level like REST API. Right. So that is something you need to handle at the backend integration level or the Lambda level. Correct. So guys, that's all I wanted to cover in this tutorial. Until that time, if you want me to do tutorial on any use case or service, then please leave them below and I will try my best to come up with the tutorial as soon as possible. And if you have any queries or comments, then again, please leave them below and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and see you next time.